Hi, my name is Stanley from Centonomy and welcome to another Tutorial Thursday. Today we're going to discuss one of the most frequently asked questions in personal finance, which is, how much should you be saving? Now, traditionally, people rely on specific percentages based on their monthly income. Should I save 10%, 20%, 30%? At Centonomy, we've gone a step further and we say that your savings should not be specifically attached to one percentage or the other, but rather they should be attached to your financial goals. What financial goals do you have? Is it educating your children, going on holiday, starting a business? Those are the ones that should determine what you should be saving per month or per year. For example, if I want to go on holiday at the end of the year and the holiday is going to cost, say, 48,000 shillings, I should work backwards and say, because I have 12 months to save, then that means that I should be saving approximately 4,000 shillings a month. Does that make sense? Okay. That is actually what Centonomy teaches. Look at your goals, look at your financial goals to be specific, and then work backwards and say, how much do I need to put aside today so that I can achieve that financial goals? So what goals do you have? Is it educating your kids? Is it going on holiday? Is it starting the business? Is it, name it, the goal is yours to determine. Put a price on it, put a figure on it, and then also put a specific timeline on it. For example, I want to educate my children in 15 years at this specific university and it's going to cost 500,000 shillings per year. Then I now understand that I have 15 years to hit that target. So what do I have to do today? How much money do I have to put aside today in savings to get me to that target? To get me to that target holiday? To get me to that target school fees? The thing that I'm going to mention about creating a vision is you should make it as specific as possible. Put that figure on it. Try and determine how much is it going to cost me to go on that holiday? How much is it going to cost me to educate these children? And then work backwards. Another thing I'm going to stress upon is put a timeline on it. How much time do I have to achieve my goal? Is it 10 years? Is it 10 months? And then that will help you to determine how much per month I should be putting aside. And that really boils down to proper planning, financial planning. Plan ahead and then work backwards. Have a vision and then work backwards. And then that will help you to determine today, what do I need to save? So for some of you, you may actually need to reevaluate your savings. Maybe you are working with a figure of 10%. Perhaps that's not enough to achieve your financial goals. Perhaps you should be putting aside more. Another thing that I'd like to mention is the difference between savings and investments. Savings is just putting money aside. An investment is money that is put aside that is also growing. I would encourage for you out there to put your money as a savings. With an earning on top. Make it an investment. Be it 10%, 20%, it's really up to you based on your priorities. Make sure it is an investment and not simply a savings. So thank you again for watching today's Tutorial Thursday and see you next week.